If you talk to everyone, you'll end up talking to no one. That is why it is important to have a reader persona. A very real person will probably define your reader demographics. How do you figure this out? The first place to start is talking to your most enthusiastic supporters. If you are a writer already, be it a writer on social media or be it a blogger, you have certain people who always read your work and maybe leave comments. These are the people you approach and ask them what specifically appeals to them about your work and where they feel you could improve. Try to figure out the common things people say. Second thing you do, if you have analytics, which is to say that you have a dashboard via social media content creation or Google Analytics or something like that for your blogging channels, you will have very specific demographic information like age, location, education, things like that. A very distinct pattern will emerge. Maybe you want to edit your language in a way that appeals to your demographic. The third thing you could do is create an ideal version of the reader you want. The reality does not have to match your ideal version. You just need to know who you want your target audience to be eventually. Another thing you could do is try childishness or childlikeness, which is to say that ask the most random questions possible. Once you have all of these things going for you, try visualizing and relating to your book, which is to say that irrespective of a fiction or a non-fiction, the person that you are writing about in the book, fictional or non-fictional, is a character in your book. You want this personality to be understandable. Readers are able to visualize what this character will do. So when you break their expectations or meet their expectations, in both cases, they are pleased. You look at the character and you try to get in their skin as much as possible without judging them. Just flesh the character out, fiction or non-fiction, as much as possible. One of the easiest ways to do that is playing the devil's advocate. Say the person will do X. This makes sense. Devil's advocate is going to say, yes, I understand that X makes sense, but then I want you to do Y, which is the diametrically opposite version of X. When you do devil's advocating, one of two things happen. Either you become sure of your original idea, or your unsurety makes you question your idea more, making you kind of refine it. Both of these are good things. You either strengthen your premise or you consider other premises. The last and final thing, in my opinion, the last and final thing you do is you identify the pain point and the value proposition of your book. See, every book will have a pain point that it addresses, fiction or non-fiction, and it will offer some value proposition in parallel with that pain point. The easiest way to counter this is to repeatedly ask yourself one question: what is in it for my readers? 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 I hope that this was helpful. If you have any follow-up questions, feel free to ask them.